But I think that the one thing that really stops diversity more than anything is fear. The worst four-letter word that has been created under God. Fear. Because it is fear that stops us from using our very simple intelligence. Where we go, there's a fire. Our intelligence go, put out the fire. But then our brain says, well, who do I have to get permission from before I put out that fire? I don't want to get in trouble for putting out that fire. And so by the time you've gone through all of these new steps that we've put into place, there is no more fire. Because the building that was burning is now gone. Okay, so now we're talking about finding the funding to rebuild the building versus just simply having to have repaired the room or the wall or the curtain. And so if we roll that all back again to this concept of diversity, let's talk about why we really don't get people in this region that are black. And I'm going to talk about black specifically first, and then I'll expand. The reason that black folks don't interact is because black folks haven't felt like they had a table, you know, a chair at the table. It's very simplistic. Now, here's the problem. The problem is 9 times out of 10, you all, and I'm going to be very stereotypical for a moment, so please forgive me, you all believe that it's your job to make that happen or to be sorry for that having not happened thus far. That is where the problem is, because it makes you not be proactive. You're still dealing with yesterday. Versus with simply dealing with tomorrow. And tomorrow simply says this, that if we are really teaching the concept of accountability from day one, then everybody will be prepared when the call is made. The reason that black folks are not coming to work at Hillside is because we're not prepared to work at Hillside. It's just that simple. The requirements that you're having, we are not ready to fulfill. Again, I'm being stereotypical, meaning that if in fact in Auburn and Lawrence School District, if in Auburn and Lawrence School District, in a 5-year period previous to last year, we had not had an African American male graduate within 5 years, not one. Okay, so that is why 2 years ago there was a call to arms. The call to arms was because the state had pretty much sent a notice that said, listen, we're going to drop the hammer. It's because this is not an acceptable number. If Auburn and Lawrence School District could not produce one African-American male in 5 years, they could graduate. Then how does Hillside have a chance in heck of having an African-American male from this region work here? The only way you do that is by lowering the bar. It's just that simple. And that sends a horrible message that we are not capable. When in fact, I would argue this, if a brother can run a drug business, he can run Hillside.
Yep.
I mean, because Hillside, you get to do in the open. They're doing all this stuff underground. Yep. You know, massive numbers, incredible moving of product, being able to do advertising and marketing without being able to advertise and market. I mean, you have to understand all the principles of business that these gentlemen employ, which are amazing. But the reality is, I'm like, somebody, let's go off book. Let's figure out a program that says, drug dealers, come here.
I will teach you as much, Sean.
Right? No, well, this is a problem. This is a problem. Like, I ain't gonna lie. This is a problem.
Make a lot more money.
This is a problem. But I also believe, to be honest with you, we have to even get better at that. I mean, we have to get better at not just advocating that there should be more money in this kind of work. I mean, because this is the work that actually saves our tomorrow. It saves our children, and it saves us. It saves us from our children. You know, I'm not just the owner, I'm a client, you know, born and raised, you know, in Malone Village, you know, and supposedly should not have been able to make the strides, you know, that we have made. And what I said to him, the issue is that that person's life was not different than mine, almost at all. It was not different than mine, almost at all. Somehow we just caught some kind of wave that took us slightly different than their wave, you know, so it's not so much that I'm better than them by any stretch of the imagination, and all the things that come with that. So there was a whole climate. And what's really funny is today what has happened, and why it's an epidemic, why it's a challenge, is that white America now is following that. See, it wasn't a problem when it was only black America. The problem now is that white America is following black America. Now America's in trouble. Because now when black America stopped doing half the things that were happening, white America has taken it and has run with it. You know, we always talk, let's talk about the hip-hop craze. Hip-hop is a very incredible form of art. And so the notion, again, is what is the climate and how have we created the vehicle to be able to make these folks feel as though they are welcome? The reality is, if I don't feel welcome in the school building, I will not feel welcome in the college, which certainly means there's no way I'm going to feel welcome in a institution such as this, an institution that carries several things with it, cultural learning, institutional learning, educational challenges. It's, you know, we say, you know, we need this at the front door. Okay, and so a lot of the different habits that you're trying to undo are the habits that we've been breeded with. And now those very habits we're talking about no longer are focused on a particular demographic anymore. You know, we talk about the melting pot, we talk about the land of the free, ta-da, we're absolutely there now. That sometimes you can meet a Caucasian who acts so, and I'm saying stereotypical black, right? Yo, what's going on? But what happens is in my house, in my neighborhood, that's not how we talk. I mean, that's not how we talk. Or Joe Cocker, that's not how Joe Cocker talks. So if we can't understand that Joe Cocker is performing and not understand that 50 Cent is performing, we go, Joe Cocker's performing, 50 Cent is being 50 Cent. No, 50 Cent's performing. He has 200,000 people out there that expect a product. He gives them that product, then he goes home and he talks like this. You know, but so what happens as a culture is we haven't given everybody the right to take off the mask. Because we all put on the mask when we see Alec Baldwin having a tirade with his child. And everyone's going, oh my gosh, this is so, are you crazy? Come on, who's not guilty? You know, if you just don't clean that room, just clean that room, just. If we take anybody's life and isolate it to a single moment, we all fail. We all fail. No one passes. Because I can tell you, if you'd have caught my mom on one of the days, okay, you know, they'd have tried to put her under the jail. Okay? But the reality is that woman is why I am who I am. And that woman is why I can see what I see. And she gave me a very clear definition of the word no. A word that no person outside my household had the ability to enforce without her help. And here lies in the greatest issue to dealing with children and getting back to how we have this diverse offering and inclusion. Is that our entire process right now has landed us in a place in which we segregate the child from the parent at every single juncture. And normally give authority to somebody that the kid doesn't know to try to get to the same end. So we say, oh, parent can't hit the kid, but we can do 5-point restraints and we can jump on them and body and roll with them in the whole nine yards. I say, let mama roll with them. The largest example of failure is watching the young men and young women who are below the age of 16 who walk down Main Street, Auburn, Genesee Street at 11 o'clock with three kids proudly. You know, so if I see this gentleman who I just saw actually at Applebee's a couple weeks ago, a black gentleman, who I know is really, really smart and I know is really, really intelligent. And I said, you know, it's really cool that you're working at Applebee's. But like, why aren't you working at Cougar Home for Children? Why aren't you working for the school district? Why aren't you working for Carrier? I'm like, you have to get past having a job and find a career. You know, you're always going, you know, Sean, I don't got enough money. That's simple, because Hess don't pay a lot. So I'm proud that you work at Hess, but the problem is jobs don't pay, careers pay. What I need you to do, my sister, is to find a career. Because a job makes you disposable. It really does. Careers make you very valuable. If you were going to get rid of her, you'd have to figure out how. There's attributes that she brings to the table that you have to replace. What do you have to replace for a person that's just hitting the button that says gas can pump?